alive to God.
I don't know where that little girl just went I just prayed with. Where's she at? She come right back through here. Where's she? She's right here. Come here, baby. Come on up here. Let's kick the devil in the teeth tonight. Amen. Did you rededicate your life tonight?
I messed my life up with my family. Mom, I'm really sorry for everything.
God bless you.
And I knew as soon as my heart was pounding really fast, I knew something was happening. I knew I had to do something to fix it.
Yes. How old are you, honey?
11.
11 years old. Pouring her heart out to God. Go hug your mama up real good in the name of Jesus.
I'm going to get up here where everybody can see me. Oh, Lord. Everybody's clenched up right now. I remember when I got saved. I was in there in that gym. This is before we built this. And I remember a couple nights before. I don't know why I'm saying this. I'm going to go ahead and say it right now. I don't know why I'm saying this. I remember waking my mom and dad up in the middle of the night, and I said, Mom and Dad, I don't want to go to hell. But I knew that I couldn't get saved just because I didn't want to go to hell. So a couple days later, I don't remember what day it was exactly. I know it was in May. I don't remember how old I was. I think I was close to 9. Is that right? But I got in there, and I felt God, and I needed him in my life, and I asked him to come in my life. And I've lived pretty bad since then. But the other day, I got in my mom's room, and I was upset because you guys know my story. Sometimes I can't feel much because I've got a brain thing going on, and sometimes I get real numb. And I ain't felt God in a long time, but I went to eat with Matthew Browder today. I took him out, and poor guy, he ain't ate all morning. Kellen's car was getting detailed. He was, he was getting it detailed, and the guy was taking forever. And I invited the guy to church. I knew him and went to school with him, but I ended up getting back. I took Matthew to lunch, and we ate, and it was good. But he was telling me the whole time, he said, you know what? Your salvation is not based in feelings. It's based in what's in the Bible. Right? I ain't gonna lie, I've struggled with my salvation since I got it right in there the first time, and I've struggled with it, and I got it right the other day, and I ain't felt God in a minute, but I felt it right there. I just want to let everybody know, I don't know what that was for, but you go ahead.
Oh, God, have your way.
Let me tell y'all something. God has answered the prayer of this woman's heart today. As far as I know, my child has never got up and told anything about what went on with her back when she was 9 years old. Let me tell y'all something. Spiritual battle is real. Spiritual battle is real. But when she was 9 years old and times were hard, I'm telling you, hard, people, I would have to walk away from her because we would be fighting and yelling. And I would go and I would sit in my recliner. And the Lord would continue to say to me, what I have started, I will finish. And I have told her all her life she's got a story to tell. She has got a story to tell. And I'm telling y'all, if she ever tells it, you will just praise Jesus for his work in all of our lives. And that song, Faith Ann, she didn't even know. My brother sent me that song Friday. And he sent me that song and I have played it. It was one of my favorites. And I told my brother, I said, when that song comes on at church, all I can do when it says, you have been faithful, all I can do is stand and raise my hands because God is so faithful. And I have listened to that song. I can play it 3 times going to work, 3 times coming home, and I can play it when I am at work. And I even found a t-shirt last night in my closet that has a verse of that song on it. That song is amazing. And for God to put that in my heart, in my brother's heart, and in my child's heart. Lord, if you play that song, I'll come. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. That he speaks to us through music, through the word, through people on stage, everywhere. Praise Jesus.
Glory, glory, glory. Sing that chorus one more time. Come on, preacher. For Matthew Browder as he come preach the word tonight.
Can the church say amen? Bless the name of Jesus. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. There's no better place than with God's people and God's presence and him manifesting his power. Somebody give him a hand clap of praise. If there's ever a time that we need revival, it's in the days that we are living in. We need to have an awareness that we are living in the last of the last days. Second Timothy chapter number 3. If you have your Bibles, would you stand to honor the reading of God's word? We stand and we honor our flag and we stand up for other things. And I believe in giving honor where honor's due. But I don't believe there's any greater honor that's due than to the Word of God. Aren't you glad that He didn't just leave us out there stranded to figure it all out by ourselves? But aren't you glad that people was inspired by the Holy Ghost to write down the Word of God so that we could have it as a roadmap in this life? in these days, in these times that we are in. And I believe that this is where we're at. 2 Timothy chapter number 3. This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good. Do you know that we are living in a day where people are calling evil good? And they're calling good evil? Traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. God, I just want to thank you publicly, not ashamed, for your word, your spirit, your love, your mercy, your forgiveness, your patience. Oh God, there's been times I've lost focus, been times I've got sidetracked, been times I've got distracted. But thank you for your patience, God. Thank you for the wooing of the Spirit. And God, if you'll help us tonight, let this little preacher step aside and the big one take over. And help me preach to this precious congregation, to those that are watching online. Give us ears to hear what the Spirit of the Lord would say tonight. God, that we may take this, and God, that we would become better, more faithful. Because God, you truly are faithful every time, every day, every moment. God, help us preach in the power and the demonstration of the Holy Ghost. Forgive us for all of our sin and bind anything that would hinder. God, we know your word will not return void, but it will accomplish that it set out to accomplish. And we give you praise in the name of Jesus Christ. Can the church say it? Amen. You may be seated. So many people are living like that they're just going to live forever down here. And we've lost the sensitivity. We've lost the awareness of the times that we are in right now. And the Bible said that this world was going to wax worse. And I'm here to tell you tonight, as sure as I'm on this stage, King Jesus is coming soon. And some people may say, well, I've heard it since I was a child. I've heard that message preached. But as you get into the Word of God and you unpack the Scriptures, you see that we're getting closer and closer and closer to the coming of our Lord. Somebody give him a hand clap of praise. Luke chapter 17, verse number 26. As it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the days of the Son of Man. They were drinking. They were marrying. They were giving in marriage. Hey, they were buying. They were selling until the day that the flood came and destroyed them all. Come on. They didn't have an awareness. Even though the preacher was preaching that it was going to rain, he was telling them, and they thought that he was crazy out there as he would hammer and he would work on that ark that God told him to build. But they was not sensitive to what the man of God was telling them. As it was, Brother Earl, in the days of Noah. Was being past tense, it means it happened before. So shall it be. It's going to happen again in the days of the Son of Man. What are you saying? People are going on about their business. Like everything's okay. Refuse to repent. Refuse to heed to what the man of God is telling them. They leave church Sunday after Sunday in the same shape that they've been in for years, even though they've worn the pew or a seat for years, and they walk out like everything's all right. But I'm here to tell you that the wrath of God is coming, and it's going to be poured out on this world. God destroyed the world because of the wickedness. People had turned from God. I believe, Brother Charlie, if we could go back, that we could say they was more lovers of themselves and more lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. Come on. Noah and his family entered the ark that God told him to build. And then God shut the door. It wasn't Noah that shut the door. It wasn't his family that shut the door. It was God that shut the door. And I'm here to tell you, we serve a God that is so mighty that he still shuts doors that no man can open. No matter how hard you try to kick it down, no matter how hard you try to drive through, when God shuts the door, it will not be opened unless he chooses to open it. He opens doors that no man can shut. They had never seen rain before. But all of a sudden, the clouds started gathering in. Oh, yes. The rain started falling. Noah and his family was in the ark of safety. I'm here to tell you, if you're not in the ark of safety, under the sound of my voice tonight, I would run to an altar. Come on. I would crawl to an altar if I had to. Because the door is open right now. We are living in the last of the last days. Today is the day of salvation, but tomorrow may be too late. The Bible said now is the accepted time. You can receive Christ as your Savior. You don't have to die and go to hell. You don't have to be destroyed by the wrath of God. The door is open. You got to walk through it. I can see them as the rain. Brother Charlotte, it started rising. That water started rising from the rain. Oh, I wonder what they was thinking. Maybe that man of God was right after all. Let's run to the ark now and get in before we drowned in this water. And I can see them as they're running to the ark. swimming to the ark, trying to get to the ark, trying to get to the door. But it was too late. I begin to think, Brother Chris, about the people that was running to the ark before the water really started rising. It's raining now. It's coming down. We're feeling something we've never felt before. But maybe the man of God was right after all. Maybe he really wasn't crazy, y'all, working on that ark. And I can see them now as they're beating on the door with all their might. Maybe some of them left their fingernail prints as an indention on that ark door, clawing. Maybe some of them left blood on that door where they was beating on the door. Let us in! We believe you now! But it was too late. We're living in the last of the last days. God is a God of love, but He is a just God, and He is also a God of wrath. Oh, come on. He's a God on this end. There's no greater love than He has. But oh, when you get to the other side of the spectrum of that, there's no greater wrath that mankind has ever known than the wrath of Almighty God.
Come on, brother, preach that.
But what some of us do, we leave church and we act like we own a playground when we are in a war zone. We have lost the sensitivity and the awareness of the times that we are living in. And as it was in the days of Lot, so shall it be in the days of the Son of Man. They were eating. They were drinking. They were going on about their business as usual. I'm going to say this. We're in a day right now that we can't do church as usual. God is wanting to take us from faith to faith and glory to glory, because you're going to need power to fight the enemy like you've never had it before. How do I know? There's people leaving ministry in the last days. The Bible said that many would depart from the faith. People's leaving the church by the droves. They don't have a desire to serve God anymore. Said that they would be drawn away by seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, and they're being blown to and fro with every wind and doctrine. If there's ever a time that we need to put our nose in this book and see what God says. Hey, mama or dad may have said it, grandpa may have said it, but if it ain't in the book, we cannot believe it. We've got to get back to the Word of God and understand that we need it in these last days. Like never before. And God rained down fire and brimstone on Sodom and Gomorrah. And Lot's wife looked back. I believe that she was already missing what God was bringing her out of. Some of you need to quit missing what God has brought you out of. And you need to celebrate the victory that you're in right now, because, hey, you didn't miss out on anything. God brought you out of a horrible pit, and He set your foot on a solid rock. Woo! And He established you, God. And He put a brand new song in your mouth, even praises unto God. My God, I feel the Holy Ghost. We're living in the last of the last days. And you that are called, God's put you to work. Young people, there's callings on your life. And Jesus said, occupy until I come. I was thinking as I was sitting over there, there's times you fill out a thing when you're filling out a form or whatever, and it will say occupation. Jesus said, occupy until I come. How long has it been since you won a soul to Christ? Have you ever won a soul to Christ? How long has it been since you testified even at the Walmart or at the gas station? How long has it been since you've not really been a shout? Oh, it's easy to come into the house of God and living in the last of the last days and say, oh, how I love Jesus, and testify. But how hard is it when you get to school? How hard is it when you get to the workplace? God's looking for some people in these last days that's unashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ and will stand. When all you can do is stand, you stand. I'm going to occupy this space. I'm going to occupy this position. I'm going to occupy in my calling that he's called me to until he comes. He destroyed the world with water the first time. And he put a rainbow in the sky as a signification that he will not destroy the world with water again. Now, I'm going to say this, and I'm going to say it if it makes the devil mad. God did not put a rainbow in the sky for the LBGT to use as their logo to promote an ungodly lifestyle. God put a rainbow in the sky as a signification, as a promise from the Word of God to let us know that he was not going to destroy the world with water again, but the next time it was going to be with fire. Oh, we're living in a time where people's calling good evil, calling good and evil good. People stand up, oh, we don't need to bring politics in the church. We're living in that kind of time too. When the Bible said that judgment begins at the house of God. The problem in living in the last of the last days, we got a lot of people that don't want to hurt feelings and they just want to go along to get along. But God's looking for a remnant of people in the last of last days that will stand up for the truth. If it makes mama mad, it makes mama mad. If it makes daddy mad, it makes daddy mad. If it makes people in the church mad, it makes them mad. God's looking for some people that I stand up and be strong and be bold and stand up for what's right. People just want to go along to get along. They've lost the awareness of the times that we are really in. The book of Daniel says before Jesus comes back, knowledge is going to increase. Man, you think there's been inventions made? If the Lord tarries his coming, wait next 5 years, if this world lasts that long. You see, I don't know how long it's going to last, and you don't either. The Bible said that no one knows the hour. Not even the angels in heaven, the Word of God tells us in the gospel. The Father is the only one that knows when that time is going to be. But when he comes, he's going to come back as a thief in the night. You're not going to have time to pack and get ready. Hey, when I'm going on vacation, I don't pack when I get there. I pack before I go. God is getting his people ready. If there's some business you need to do with God, you better do it right now. When Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives and the disciples came to him privately saying, tell us about these things and tell us the sign of when you're going to be coming and when the end of the world is going to be. Matthew chapter 24. And Jesus answered and saith unto them, take heed that many is going to come in my name saying I am Christ, and they are going to deceive many. Oh, let me tell you something. Everything that has a God tag on it does not mean that it's of God. There's people that say, God bless you, but they're living a life. They're living under a curse because they're not living for God. They've not surrendered to God. There's people that have put a God tag on things to draw people in. But you better try the spirits living in the last of last days and see if they be of God. There's something else we need in the last of the last days. We need some discernment. I want to say this. I don't say it to puff a man up or to blow smoke, but I thank God for a pastor in Hayesville, North Carolina, that operates in the discernment of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. People wonder why their church, if they're listening on, people wonder why their church services are dry, why they're dead and plucked up by the roots, why there's nothing happening, why people are not getting saved, why people are not getting healed, why people are not being filled with the Holy Ghost. It's because they've lost discernment. They have a form of godliness, but deny the power thereof. But in the last days, he said, I'm going to pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and sons and daughters, they shall prophesy. I'm glad the Spirit of God is alive and he's pouring it out on his people that will receive it. Are we sung in those churches dead as a hammer? People more concerned about programs and formality than they are the moving of the Holy Ghost. These last days, we need discernment. They're asking him, when are we going to know what's going to be the sign that you're coming? He said, many's going to come in his name. They're going to deceive many. He said, you're going to hear of wars and rumors of wars. Hear of wars. There's war going on in Ukraine right now. But rumors of wars, we're hearing it, how China could go into war with us and Russia could go into war with us anytime. And he said not to be troubled. You see, us that are saved and know the Word of God, we don't have to live in fear. And we don't have to be troubled. You remember what he told them before he went away in John chapter 14? He said, let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. And I'm going away to prepare a place for you. And if I go away to prepare a place for you, I will come again to receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. We don't have to be worried. We don't have to be troubled. He said, but the end is not yet. He said, kingdom is going to rise against kingdom. Or nation against nation. And kingdom against kingdom. He said that there's going to be famines. Oh, we're living in a time that we don't just have a famine for food or something to drink, but we're living in a time where there is a famine for the Word of God. We're living in a time where people want a feel-good message. I want to feel good when I leave church. Oh, but my God, if we can get the Word down in us and we can get our feet stomped on and we can get our hearts convicted by this book, we can draw a little bit closer to Him in these last days. And my God, if we can get in this book and live for Him and Him live in us and through us and be pleased with us, that's all that matters. So famines and pestilence. pestilence. You know what coronavirus was? It was pestilence. It tells us it's going to happen before he comes. And then he said there's going to be earthquakes in divers places. Have you ever heard a time where people are experiencing earthquakes in areas where it don't even really make sense? In the book of Zechariah, in the book of Ezekiel, it talks about the Dead Sea being healed and it's going to come alive. If you can ask people that's been over to Israel, they will tell you, and there is information, Brother Earl, that there's fresh water that's coming into the Dead Sea now, and even schools of fish that they have found in the Dead Sea. I'm here to tell you, Bible prophecy is being fulfilled, and we are living in the last of the last days. What God said will come to pass.
I believe it.
Going on, he said that false prophets would rise up. Oh, have you ever seen a time people telling you this and that? People telling you there's other ways to heaven besides Jesus Christ. Some even people tell us that we can be our own gods. We was in Dayton, Ohio. And we was checking in the room, and David had already went in. My brother David, y'all met him. He's such a blessing. I love my brother, love my family. Did y'all enjoy the family? Man, we were so blessed. I know they enjoyed being with you. Sonia said before they left in the bus last night, she said we wouldn't have missed it for the world. But I went in to the hotel, and there was a lady at the counter, and I was ready to get to my room, Brother Charlie. I was ready to get in there, relax, get bed down, and I get on the elevator. I've got my suitcase, and I feel like the Lord's saying, go back and talk to her. And I'm thinking, I want to get to my room. How many's ever God told you to do something, you just thought, well, I'll do it later, or right now I don't feel like it. So I went up the elevator there to the floor where my room was, got ready to step off, and man, I just felt like the Lord was, and I'd already kind of argued with the Lord just a little bit, like, well, it's just going to be me and that woman, and that ain't going, and then he reminded me of the woman at the well, so I couldn't get out of it. So I went back downstairs, and I started witnessing to her. Well, if what she was saying, I'm like, why did I really come back down? Are you a Christian? Oh, yeah. She talked about how that she participated in church activity. And, man, I'd witnessed this girl for a while, and I'm thinking, man, I was running out of ideas. I didn't know. I'm thinking, man, I've been down here. Why did I come down here for? But I knew that there was a purpose.
Yes, sir.
Then when I started talking about God, we agreed that God is a spirit. And I started talking about Jesus and what he did. And I could tell right then that she wasn't on the same page. And I thought, that's why I'm here. Because unless... Now you hear me, we got false prophets in the world that's rising up today, and people's believing it. You can believe in God all you want. There's a lot of gods in the world. India worships over 1 million gods. But the difference in my God and their God is my God had a son called Jesus Christ, who was born a virgin birth in Bethlehem. And he did what he did because of who he is. And I told her, I said, wait a minute, unless you believe that he did what he did and he is who he is, that's the only way you can be saved. You give me this stuff, you're closer to God. And you've heard this. Me and God, we got an understanding. I'm telling you, your understanding better be, God, not my will, but thine be done in these last days. I want to live for you. I want to do what you want me to do. Yes. Moving on, the Bible said that because much iniquity abounds, the love of many would wax cold. Have you seen so many people cold on God?
Oh, yes.
What's happening here and other places around the globe, it's an unusual thing that's happening. There's a stirring that's going on. There's a pouring out of His Spirit that is going on. Because you need more than just coming to church to stand in these last days. You need the Spirit of God who will give you boldness and help you stand in these last days. And we see it. The love of many's wax cold. You ever see a candle when it's lit, how the wax just runs down the candle? Because it's lit. The light's on. But what happens whenever the candle is blown out? That wax dries against the part of that candle and it hardens. You know what's happened? People's let their lamps go out. They've quit refilling it with oil. What they've done, it reminds me of Matthew chapter 25, verse 1 through 13, how there was 10 virgins. There was 5 wise, and there was 5 foolish. The wise virgins had oil in their lamps, waiting on the bridegroom to come. The 5 foolish had no oil in their lamps. And when the bridegroom came, the 5 foolish thought that they could borrow oil from the 5 wise virgins. Now let me tell you this. You can't get to heaven trying to borrow what your mama has, what the pastor has, what the teacher has. Hey, you got to get to heaven the same way we all going to get that. You got to get oil in your lap for yourself. I can't borrow it off my daddy. I can't borrow it off Pastor Chris. I can't borrow it off Charlie. I've got to get oil in my lamp for myself, because I know that the bridegroom is coming, because I'm living in the last of the last days. And when the bridegroom came, they didn't even have time to go down to the marketplace and get the oil. He is going to come like a thief in the night, and you're not going to have time to get it right. What are you trying to say? We're living in the last of the last days. If you're going to get it right, then get it right now. Somebody give Him some praise. Can we all stand right now all over the house? Jesus is coming. He said in Matthew chapter 24, He said that this gospel is going to be preached all over the world. And He said, then the end is going to come. There's places that are not getting the gospel. But I'm here to tell you, because of the way of internet and the way of technology, more and more are hearing the gospel. Even those in foreign countries that are living up in the mountains and in the woods, they're getting the gospel. What are you trying to say? I'm saying that it's getting close. Jesus is coming. If you're here and you're lost, or you don't know for sure that you're saved, or maybe there's just some business that you need to do with God to repent. The Bible said, whosoever covereth his sins shall not prosper. But whosoever we'll confess them and forsake them, we'll have mercy. And that's repentance. Eyes closed all over the building. God, thank you for the liberty to preach your word. Lord, I feel the wind of revival in this place. Right now, you that need to do business with God, I wouldn't stay there in your seat any longer. Just step out of your seat. Say, it's not my brother, it's not my sister, it's not my wife, it's not my friends, but it's me, oh Lord, that stands in need of prayer tonight. Maybe you just need to rededicate that relationship that you have with Christ. You need to rededicate it tonight. You need to say, God, I've really not been occupying. I've not been doing what you want me to do. I've not really been the witness that you called me to be. And God, I believe that we're living in the last of the last days. And God, I want to get it right now. Listen, if you don't know Jesus as your Savior, He's the only way to heaven. He will save you tonight. You can leave this place with a no soul in your soul that you are saved. He lived a perfect life. He walked the road to Calvary. No man took his life from him, but he freely laid it down. And he said, I don't only have the power to lay down my life, I've got the power to take it back up again. He was placed in a tomb, but on the third morning, he got up victorious over death, hell, and the grave. And whenever they watched him go away, they said in like manner, he is going to come back one day. He left with a shout. He's coming back with a shout. He's coming back in the eastern sky. And he's coming back in the clouds in power and glory. And he's taken his church home with him. We got a lot to look forward to. There's more that need to come tonight. The Lord is speaking to your hearts. People have come, but I believe, as sure as I'm standing here, that God has more for you, but you got to get to the place that you will surrender more to Him. You got to get to the place of consecration. You got to get to the place where you say, God, I'm going to humble myself. God bless you, brother. God bless you, sister. I'm going to humble myself under your mighty hand. Oh, God, I feel your conviction power in this place. Oh, I'd run to an altar if I had to. You that's in the balcony up there, if you need to do business with God, young or old, it doesn't matter. Come right now. Come right now. Why, He's nigh. The Bible said there'll come a day that people will call to Him, but He won't answer. Oh, but right now, today's the day of salvation. Right now, He's wanting to do something in your life. People's coming. Oh, saints of God, pray tonight. I feel the waters troubled in this house. And I believe, there's some, you just need to lay some things down tonight. You need to say, I've struggled with it long enough. And now I'm aware of the times that we're really in. That we are really getting close to the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. There's a sense of urgency tonight. Maybe some of you have lost loved ones that you need to come and pray for. Come and do it right now. Come on right now. Don't wait. Call out their names to God. I'm telling you, there's a heaven to gain and a hell to shun. Oh, oh God, oh God. Sing that I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Oh God, in the name. Oh, in the name of Jesus.
Number one.
Saint Charlie. In the name of Jesus. God, I pray for these young people. God, pour out your spirit through them, in them, God. In the name of Jesus. As they empty out to you, God, help them, God, in these last days to stand, God, for you. Oh, God, help us, God, be an example. Help us, God. Oh, but I can't even walk.
But I can't even walk.
Oh, God, I need you. Oh, how many would say, I can't even walk. I can't even walk.
Oh, I can't even walk without you holding my hand.
I tried it. I can't do it by myself.
Mountain to high.
Oh, God, forgive us.
I can't even walk
without you holding. we're so hopeless and helpless. God, we're weak without you. We need you, God. God, we need your touch. Oh, God, we need your touch. God, I pray, Lord, you continue to do your job.
Praise the name of the Lord. God is good. Okay. Brother Danny's calling for the elders of the church to come at this time to be anointed and prayed over. His brother and his wife has COVID right now. We want to pray. How many of you believe in the power of prayer? Yes, sir. Amen. If you don't believe, we ask you to step outside, but we believe in the power of the Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, God, bless your name.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Jesus, Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
God, as they stand.
Kind Jesus. Lord, we love
God,
you.
God, you said we're too
God, we thank you, Lord, for your many blessings.
Jesus,
tonight we come before you on behalf of Bill and Sue. And God, I pray, Jesus, Lord, that you'd just touch their bodies right now. Lord, we know that you're able. God, I pray, Father, that you go to where they are right now. God, you touch their bodies. Lord, I praise you, Lord. You're Jehovah Rapha, you're God, our healer. And God, your word says, Lord, with your stripes, we are healed. God, we ask this now. God, we ask it, Lord, in the name above all other names. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name, almighty name, we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Can you give God praise for what he's doing right now?
Touch me.
Oh, all God's people shouted? Amen, amen, amen. Do y'all like revival? Well, praise God, we'll be back tomorrow night. Wesley Campbell's going to be here. It's going to be fantastic. You don't want to miss it. Every night's just going to be great. And listen, I'm telling you, I know last night that people were tired. I was one of the ones that was tired. I had to teach physical education today to little fellers. And I was tired, but I'm telling you, when I heard Brother Charlie start saying, how about it from my little buddy, Charlie Lambert, huh? He hit some notes on that piano that encouraged me, that strengthened me, brought me to my feet. And let me tell you something, we need to continue. Revival is going on in our youth and in our schools like never before. And we need to cultivate that. We need to fan the flame of that. Young people, keep it up. Some of our college kids rededicated tonight. We had 5 rededications tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Did you appreciate Brother Browder sharing that word? Amen. Well, listen, we hope that you can be back tomorrow. We love you. We thank you for being here. And it'll be at 7 o'clock, 6:45 in the prayer room. Next 3 nights, it's going to be good. Something that Brother Johnny talked about to me, and we wanted to share it. And we want you to spread the word on social media. We know that Friday is going to be youth night. And we're really, really hitting our schools hard. And God is doing a new work in the schools. But we're tagging something on. It's going to be student teacher night. So we want all the teachers from our schools to come. Because if we can get the teachers here, and the teachers get revival, and the coaches get revival, and the administrators get revival, we may even get some school board members in before it's over. Have revival. That's what it's going to take. It's going to take you going to the Lord in prayer and then reaching out in faith. That's what it's going to take. How many of you is willing to do that? And let's covenant together. We will reach them in the name of Jesus. Let's get our hands up in the air. Let's exercise. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. May God bless you. Be safe and good night.